It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Officer at Payne Capital Management. And the market was driven higher this week by earnings, especially from big technology companies, and also announcements from the ECB, the European Central Bank, that announced that their stimulus would linger longer, widening a gap between monetary policy expectations in the Eurozone and that in the U.S. You see, Europe is continuing their quantitative easing program, while in the U.S., not only are they going to raise rates next month, but they're also no longer implementing quantitative easing. And that's one of the reasons why we see the 10-year German Bund yielding less than a half of 1% and the U.S. 10-year Treasury at 2.45%. The spread between those two yields is the widest since 1999 of over 2%. So will U.S. rates continue to go up? Well, you got to wonder. If you're a big German insurance company, those yields at around 2.5% in the U.S. look a lot more attractive than less than a half a percent, you know, over in Germany. Meanwhile, earnings keep coming in at record numbers, and the big reports this week came from both old and new tech, with companies like Amazon and Google blowing out numbers late Thursday evening. But we also saw good numbers from the old technology companies, Microsoft and Intel, both being driven to all-time record highs. And that's why we're seeing this year so far that growth stocks are outperforming value stocks, almost on a 2-to-1 ratio. For example, growth companies are up close to 22% this year, while the value index is up around 12. But the big winner is still the emerging markets. And don't forget, emerging markets are heavily driven by technology. So with technology measured by the NASDAQ 100, the QQQ is up around 26%, is now tied with emerging markets at around the same level. And the big news on the week is commodities finally showing a positive return for the year. Now, commodities are down as much as double digits earlier in the year, but with the move in oil above $50 a barrel, both Brent and West Texas crude, commodity prices have been creeping up ever since. Now, that means there's probably more inflation in the system than the Federal Reserve recognizes. That's something we're going to need to keep an eye on.